Hi Taurus, welcome to my channel. This is a special reading session for you, Taurus. I hope you're okay. I hope you're fine. The reading for today is Will They Reach Out Tarot reading session for you. This is for the sign of Taurus, okay? As you can see, Taurus, I have already shuffled the card and pre-picked the card for you. So let's start your reading. So there's going to be two readings for today. One reading is someone in the past and one reading is someone recent or active connection. All right, let's see who is gonna reach out to you, connect or reconnect to you from the past. Okay, for some of you guys, you will not resonate here, you might resonate here, or vice versa, or both. But if you're manifesting someone in the past, an ex, or you have a ghosting or on and off situation, the first reading is yours. Okay, so let's start with the first reading. Okay, someone in the past, you've got the King of Wands, the Three of Swords, and the Lover's card. Okay, you could be dealing with a Gemini, Libra, and Aquarius, and Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, and the King of Wands. What I'm getting in here, Taurus, is that there's nothing to worry. I think for some of you, Taurus, you started to have a communication from someone in the past, okay? It did not proceed because it needs more of a healing or understanding, okay? I feel like these two cards in here, this speaks about the past between the two of you. A recent past connection, okay? This is an ex, or you were dating this person on and off. There was a bit of inconsistency between the two of you. A split, a breakup. I see that. I feel that intuitively. I think this person withdraw. You know, they have an attempt. I feel like these two cards in here, they have an attempt to connect or reconnect with you, Taurus. Okay. But it was interrupted, or they changed their mind. They're needing more time to think and heal. Like they feel that it's not yet time for you and them to continue whatever it is that was interrupted, or whatever it is that that's for somehow split up between the two of you. They did attempt it. Okay, I see and feel an attempt to your person and yourself, but it did not materialize. I see you and your person reaching out and showing care and compassion and empathy around May and June. Okay. In the beginning of the reading, I was telling you there's nothing to worry. Eight of Wands. This person is the one who will reach out. If you look at the Three of Swords, okay, this is healing, moving on, and forgetting whatever, and having the courage to forget the past. In the next picture, you've got the Lover's card. So one of the sword, the Lover's card, the angel in here, they are using the sword from the Three of Swords. They took one and they use this to heal or connect the two of you. So this is a person where you feel like, and you felt like they have given up, or you lose hope and something like that. But there's some sort of given up, or there was a messy breakup, a huge fight that you never in your life expect that they would call or text you. Like you lost hope. There's nothing to worry. This person is going to do the work. They're going to bind you and them. The reason why they're binding you or connecting, reconnecting with you, it's after all that pain and drama and breakup, you are still the one. You still have one sword, the exact sword that hurt you or hurt them. This is the exact thing that would bind you together. It's very powerful. This is painful. It is pierced, but it is the one that is solid enough to be close, to make you close together. In short, sometimes, you know, the challenges, the pain, the struggle that we experience to a person, it's so deep that when we move on to that, then we are keen to kind of have more of that person, because it's more of, if we have defy this Three of Swords, then we could be together long term. Okay, so yeah, there's some sort of an awakening that your person has realized, because they want to forge you and them. Like this is the sword from here, They want to forge your alignment. And the Eight of Wands is in reverse. You don't need to worry. This arrow is shooting the Lover's card. There's nothing to worry. There's nothing for you to do or action to do because this is their work. Okay? I see it happening May, June, July, August. Okay? By August, you would have some sort of an outcome. This is someone who is really, really important to you. This is someone you desire, you pray that you will get back together. Okay? And when I said that, the lights blink. So yeah, the spirit is all into agreement of what I am delivering right now. So good luck. This is really exciting. Okay? So that's the first reading for you, Taurus. Now the second reading is for someone recent, Taurus. You've got Nine of Swords, the Ten of Pentacles, and the Page of Pentacles and the Queen of Pentacles. So I see this person reaching out, and it's not just reaching out, it's overwhelming of reaching out. I feel like this person, Nine of Swords in reverse and Ten of Pentacles in upright position, right now this person's mind is preoccupied by work, by travel, by finances. You know, they're kind of, they're stuck in their head about stability. Okay, then they will realize that they're putting their effort in money, in travel, in stability, in something that's not related to love or romantic. They realize that this is not working. Okay, it's more of, I should be, I don't know, maybe because of what's happening to the world, or we are all working from home, isolated, locked down, shut down. So this person decided to put things on hold in terms of career, travel, finances, like, okay, enough of this career, finance, and travel, and project, and gym, or socializing, enough of this. Let me just pay my attention to Taurus, okay? So I see this person reaching out to you. It's more of this person is like, you don't have a competition now, all right? So this is them offering to you, overwhelming you with calls and texts that, hey, I have a lot of free time. There's nothing working in my, it's a person who is, okay, let's utilize this time, okay? My work, my travel, my finances, it's not really inspiring or really not looking exciting right now. So let me shift my attention to Taurus and offer my whole attention to Taurus. Because this is like, look at this lady. It's like offering you, take it, get it. It's all yours unconditionally. In the past, you have competition and you have some sort of, I feel like you have competition in terms of career, travel, or kids, but this is not working. So they would shift to Queen of Pentacles, where they would reach out and offer you some sort of unlimited call or text, like, come, baby. Like, come. It's really inviting, you know. This lady in here, the Queen of Pentacles, it looks like it's convincing you all out, okay? You could be dealing with Capricorn, Taurus, or a Virgo because this is earthly energy, or Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Like, look at this animal, this creature here. Like, your person has said, enough of the worries and concern. Let me shift my attention to Taurus. Like, I can't do anything with finances, travel, my gym, all those sort of stuff that's related to the delay that's happening to us. Let me just get back to my Taurus, okay? So yeah, this is you. This is you, Taurus. This is your person and yourself. I feel like this person is still hidden somewhere, but they would come out in the dark. They would come out in the dark and offer you this Pentacles very soon. So good luck to you. For some of you, 10 days from now, after 2 weeks. So good luck. You've got this person coming back and reaching out to you. Enjoy this attention. Okay? So this is you, Taurus. Thank you so much for tuning in. Thanks for being here today. If you like the reading, don't forget to click like. Don't forget to click subscribe. For guest viewers, guys, I would really be happy if you click subscribe, click the bell, and wherever you are right now, stay safe, be safe. Okay? Bye-bye.